lost in the storm. You are the way in the song. You are the light. Just like a child, I get distracted and wander away, but your touch is kind, and back in your arms I am safe. And though I am small, you never laugh at me when I fall down. But love through it all, counting each tear is your own. You are the light in my dark. You are the cry in my heart. You are the rest in the snow. You are the way in the sun.
Praise, praise. Amen. Settle down na po tayo, mga magulang at kapatid. Magandang umaga po sa bawat isa. Amen. Mag-umpisa na po ang ating worship service. Amen. Praise the Lord. Ushers, can you please assist our brethren to please settle down? Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord. Settle down po muna ang bawat isa bago po tayo mag-umpisa. Ang ating pong Panginoon ay God of order. Amen. Panatilihin po natin ang katahimikan at mag-umpisa na pong ating worship service. Amen. Praise the Lord. Amen. Praise God. Isang malakas na palakpak po sa ating nag-iisang Diyos na buhay. Amen. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Another worship service, another opportunity and privilege to worship our one true God, Jesus Christ. Amen. It is written in 2 Timothy chapter 4, verses 3 to 4, "For the time will come when they will not endure sound doctrine, but after their own lust shall they heap to themselves teachers having itching ears And verse 4, and they shall turn away their ears from the truth, and they shall be turned unto fables. Amen. Tunay nga po, nadarating po ang araw, and it is really on time, na paminsan, ang mga tao po hindi, ayaw na po nilang makinig sa sound doctrine. Ayaw na po nilang makinig ng word of God. Dahil ayaw po nilang masaktan sa salita ng Panginoon. Dahil ayaw na po nilang magbago. At anong hahanapin nila? Hahanapin lang nila kung anong maganda sa kanilang pakinig. Amen. Hahanapin lang nila kung anong magkikater sa kung saan sila nakasadlak, nakasalanan. Ba't tayo po naman na nanampalatay, nais po nating magbago, di po ba? Amen. Kaya na po, kahit na po masakit ang salita ng Panginoon, still nandito pa rin po tayo dahil araw-araw po patuloy po tayong binabago ng ating Panginoon. Amen. Praise God. Kaya palakpakan po natin ang ating nag-iisang Diyos na buhay na patuloy po tayong binibigyan ng pag-asa. Amen. Praise the Lord. Kaya itong araw na ito, magalak po ang bawat isa. Let us rejoice that this is the day of hope. Amen po ba? That we will again hear the word of our Lord Jesus Christ. So let us all arise. And I would like to call Brother Marvin to lead us in the praise and worship. Amen. Praise the Lord. Isa pa pong malakas na palakpak po sa ating Panginoong Jesus. Amen. Praise God.
Amen. Good morning po sa bawat isa. Narito naman tayo, parang kahapon lang. Ngayon, Friday na naman. Amen. Amen. Praise God, ang bilis po ng panahon, eh, no? Bilis ng araw. At ngayon, nandito na naman po tayo, sama-sama na naman tayo, magpupuri sa ating Panginoon. Amen. Hallelujah. Palakpakan po natin ang ating Panginoon. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Come on, church. Worship Him. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Worship Him. Come on, church. Hallelujah. Yes, Jesus, salamat po, Panginoon. Come on, church. Oh, yes, Jesus. Worship the Lord. Come on, church. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Praise you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Narito kami ngayon, Panginoon, sa umagang ito. Lalapit sa iyo. Patuloy mong siyasatin ang bawat puso po namin, Panginoon. Sa oras na ito, Ikaw lang ang nasa isip namin, sa puso namin. Ikaw lamang, Panginoon, Lord, ang aming paglilingkuran. Purihin ka. Purihin ka, Panginoon. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Siyasatin mo, Jesus, ang puso ko sa kasalanang nagawa laban sa'yo. Nagtatapat, sumasamo, dumudulog sa harap ng banal mong trono. Lumalapit, di man karapat dapat sa kabanalan mo. Biyaya, kaawaan, kapatawaran sa'yo ay nakamtan ko, O aking Jesus. Siyasatin mo, Jesus, ang bawat puso po namin sa umagang ito. Siyasatin mo, Jesus, ang puso ko sa kasalanan nagawa laban sa'yo. Nagtatapat, sumasamo, dumudulog sa harap ng banal mong trono. Lumalapit, di man karapat dapat sa kabanalan mo. Biyaya, kaawaan, kapatawaran sa'yo ay nakamtan ko, O aking Jesus. Lumalapit, come on, church, Lumapit po tayo sa ating Panginoon.
Pagdapat sa kabanalan mo, biyaya, kawaan, kapatawaran sa'yo ay nakantan ko, O aking Jesus.
Bistan pa! Lumapit po tayo sa Kanya! Come on, church!
Di ba karapat-dapat sa kabanalan mo? Biyaya, kawaan, kapatawaran sa'yo ay nakamtan ko, O aking Jesus. Ay nakamtan ko, O aking Jesus. Ay nakamtan ko, O aking Jesus. Purihin ka sa umagang ito, Panginoon. Purihin ka, Panginoon. Sinasamba ka namin, Panginoon. Sambahin
po, Panginoon, sa umagang ito. Salamat po. Minsan pa, idinako mo po ang bawat isa rito upang purihin ka, sambahin ka, Panginoon, makapakinig ng iyong mga salita. Salamat po, Panginoon Lord, sa lakas na binigay mo, sa kagalingan sa bawat isa sa amin. Salamat po sa isang buwan na lumipas. Salamat po sa mga biyaya na aming tinanggap. Salamat po sa pag-iingat mo sa bawat pamilya po namin. Salamat po, Panginoon, sa buhay na ito. At narito kami ngayon sa umagang ito. Sasamba sa iyo. I-bless mo po ang gawain ito, Panginoon. Ikaw, Panginoon, ikaw lamang ang aming pupurihin at sasambahin. Sa pagkakataong ito, pinupuri ka namin, sinasamba, pinasasalamatan. Ito po ang aming samadalangin sa iyong pangalan, aming Panginoong Jesucristo. Amen.
Hallelujah! Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus.
Amen. Praise the Lord. Nakakaupo na po muna pandalian. Amen. Praise God. Muli po, isa pong pinagpalang umaga po sa bawat isa. Amen. Praise the Lord. Lights on po. Ganun din po sa ating mga live stream viewers and good morning po or good afternoon po sa inyong lahat. Amen. Of course, sa ating po mga first time visitors, good morning. Amen. Praise God. So, amen. Purihin po ang Panginoon. Ang dami po nating mga kapatiran na sa unang pagkakataon ay ating pong makakasama. Amen. Welcome po. Oh, we would like to welcome Sister Tina from China. Amen. Praise God. Amen. Welcome. And of course, from the Philippines, we also have Sister Lourdes. Where is Sister Lourdes? Welcome po. Also, we have Sister Jocelyn. Amen. Welcome. Welcome po. We also have Sister Arlene. Welcome po. Sister Arlene is there. And Sister Marcel. Where is Sister Marcel? Amen. Amen. And welcome Brother Bernardo. Where's Brother Bernardo? Amen. Praise the Lord. And we also have representative of Bahrain. We have Brother Eunice. Amen. Praise God. Amen. And welcome back to Brother Abdullah. Amen. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Amen. Nakaka-bless po. Ang dami po natin mga bagong makakasama na magpuri sa ating nag-iisang Diyos na buhay. And surely, God has a wonderful plan kung bakit po kayo nakaupo ngayon dyan sa inyong mga kinaupuan. Amen. Praise God. Sa ating pong mga English speakers, meron po tayong brethren na mag-i-interpret po sa inyo, especially during the message. Amen. Isang malakas na palakpak pa nga po sa ating Panginoon. Amen. Praise God. Welcome back po sa ating mga kapatid na matagal din po natin hindi nakasama. Amen. I will not mention your name. Amen. But welcome back po. Amen. Praise God. Para hindi po sila ma-conscious. Amen. Praise the Lord. Of course, welcome din po sa ating mga live streamers. From the Philippines, we have Sister Scarlett. We also have Sister Lorraine. From Bahrain, we have Brother Chris Cruz. From Philippines, we have Sister Kat Santos. Amen. From Qatar, we have Brother Marlon. And also, we have Brother Ryan na nasa bakasyon. Amen. Praise God. And from USA, we have Sister Harriet. From Oman, we have Brother Hervey, Sister Gwen, and family. Amen. Praise God. Surely na napakabuti po ng Panginoon, gaya po ng ating inawit, na nagpapasiyasat po tayo sa ating Panginoon, na paminsan we feel that we are not worthy to stand in the holy presence of our Lord Jesus Christ. But kung humihingi po tayo, bukal sa loob po natin, na tapat po tayo na humihingi po ng patawad sa ating Panginoon, He is faithful and just to forgive us. Amen. Gaya po ng sinabi ko po kanina, araw-araw po may pag-asa. Araw-araw, binabago tayo ng ating Panginoon. Amen. At mapalad po tayo na nandito po tayo ngayon, handa po nating pakinggan kung ano man ang message ni Lord. Masakit man ito or hindi, masaktan ka man o hindi, you are willing to change for God. Amen po ba? Amen. Kaya naman po, palakpakan po natin ang ating Panginoon. Amen. Tunay po na binabago tayo araw-araw ni Lord. Kaya tumayo po tayo, umawit po tayo na may kagalakan sa ating Panginoon. Amen. Happy day! Amen. Again and again, sinasabi ko po, bawal po ang killjoy sa gawain ng Panginoon. This is the time that we will sing praises to our one true God, Jesus Christ. Let us practice raising our hands. Let us all raise our hands. Amen. Praise God. Itataas po natin ang ating mga kamay, tanda po ng pagsuko sa ating Panginoon. Amen. Praise God. Pangungunahan po tayo ng ating worship leader. Amen.
Praise the Lord! Sabi nga po eh, binabago tayo araw-araw ng Panginoon, di po ba? Amen! Hindi lang po yung pagbabago ng itsura natin dahil sa mga cosmetic na yan. Dapat po eh, mabago yung nandito sa puso natin. Praise the Lord! Amen po ba? Hallelujah! Praise God! Napakabuti po ng ating Panginoon. At ang bawat isa po ay puntahan, lalo na po especially yung mga bago nating nakasama sa oras na ito, puntahan po natin. Ano po natin sila. Amen. Kamayan. Praise God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Purihin ka, Panginoon.
Binabago mo ako araw-araw. Binabago mo ako araw-araw. Binabago mo ako araw-araw. Binabago mo ako araw-araw. Ngayon, bukas at kailanman, ang pag-ibig mo ay laging sapat.
Kababayan po.
Bago mo
Praise God!
Pinabago mo ako araw-araw. Pinabago mo ako araw-araw. Pinabago mo ako araw-araw. Ngayon, bukas at kailanman ang pag-ibig mo ay laging sapat.
Hallelujah! Woo!
Pinabago mo ako araw-araw. Pinabago mo ako araw-araw. Pinabago mo ako araw-araw. Pinabago mo ako araw-araw. Ngayon, bukas at kailanman ang pag-ibig mo ay laging sapat.
Pinabago!
Pinabago mo ako araw-araw. Pinabago mo ako araw-araw. Pinabago mo ako araw-araw. Pinabago mo ako araw-araw. Ngayon, bukas at kailanman ang pag-ibig mo ay laging sapat.
Pag-ibig ng Diyos!
Pag-ibig ng Diyos ay laging sa iwa. Sa bawat umaga kay ganda. Kaya dapat lang na ang buhay ko
sa umaga ay laging bago! Pinabago! 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 Pinabago!
Ngayon, bukas at kailanman ang pag-ibig ko ay laging sa
pinabago! Woo!
Ngayon, bukas at kailanman ang pag-ibig ko ay laging sa pan.
Pinabago po tayo ng ating Panginoon. Amen! Hallelujah! Hiningal ako ah! Praise God! Amen! Napakasarap po magpuri sa ating Panginoon ah! Ala, diretso na natin? O may mga announcement pa? Announcement? Okay. Kala ko makakapagpahinga ako. Amen! Praise God!
Praise the Lord. Upo muna po tayo, panandalian. Amen. Praise God. Para makahinga muna. Amen. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Are you happy, church? Amen. Praise the Lord. It's a happy day. Amen. Praise God. Amen. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. At purihin po ang ating Panginoon. We would just like to reiterate that our Bible study in Nadlia has started. Amen. Praise God. It is in the flat. It is in Jafair, amen, Brother Raj Flat, in Brother Raj Flat. Yeah, last Saturday po, we already started, and we are encouraging our international brethren to be there. Amen, praise the Lord. So if you have invited a foreign or an international brethren, brother or sister, you can course them through to Brother Raj Bible Study. Amen. It will be led by our two elders, Elder Ricky and Elder Gary. Amen. Ang Bible Study po doon, it starts at 8 o'clock, 7:30 in the evening. Amen, praise the Lord. Tunay po na nakaka-bless po na even po our international brethren, we are letting them study the Word of God. Amen. We started last Saturday with Brother Raj's testimony. Amen. How God worked in his life. Amen. Praise the Lord. So, hindi po imposible that even our international brethren, we can reach them. Amen. Praise God. We can reach them from darkness into marvelous light. At ang Panginoon po ang kikilos. Basta tayo po, magtatanim lang po tayo, magtatanim. Ang Panginoon po ang magpapalago. Amen po ba? Amen. Praise the Lord. At ganun din po, patuloy pa rin po ang ating mga gawain tuwing Sabado din po sa tahanan po ni Les Brother Archie and Sister Chanda. Bible study po doon na 8 o'clock. Amen. Praise the Lord. Ganun din po sa Rasruman. Amen. Kila Brother Melvin at Sister Len. 8 o'clock din po ang gawain. At sa umaga, Don Wash, of course. Nakaka-bless po. Ang dami pong nag-a-attend ngayon sa ating Don Wash. Purihin po ang ating Panginoon. Amen. Praise the Lord. Ang Dawn Watch po natin, for the info of everybody, our Dawn Watch, our morning prayer starts at 5 o'clock in the morning. Amen. Kaya pagising mo pa lang, you are already excited to talk and pray to our one true God, Jesus Christ. Amen. Praise the Lord. And of course, Sunday, our worship service starts at 8 o'clock in the evening sa ating pong church sa Muharak. Amen. Praise God. And Monday, every Monday, we have our prayer warrior, 8 o'clock in the evening up until 10 o'clock. And Tuesday, we have our Bereans. Amen. Tunay po na nakaka-bless po na pinag-aaralan din po natin ang salita ng ating Panginoon. And this coming Tuesday, we are inviting everybody. Amen. We are going to have an activity regarding our lesson about new birth experience. Amen. So you are very much welcome. Lahat po ng mga pinag-aralan natin for the past 3 weeks, incorporate po natin, ilalagay natin sa isang activity para mas magkaroon po ng retention ang pinag-aaralan natin. And of course, Thursday, we have the practice of praise and worship. And Friday, still we have our Ashraf encounter. And just to remind everybody, our worship service every Friday starts at 10 o'clock in the morning. Amen po ba? Hindi po 10:30. 10 o'clock po. Amen. Let us make it a point that before 10 o'clock, nandito na po tayo na nag-aantay po sa presensya ng Panginoon. Hindi po ang Panginoon ang naghihintay sa atin. Amen po ba? Amen. Praise the Lord. Kaya palakpakan po natin ang ating Panginoon. Amen. Praise God.
Amen. Nakabawi. Praise God. Sa iyo lang to, Panginoon, ang kalakasan. Di po ba? Kalakasan natin eh, para sa Panginoon lang eh. Praise the Lord. Amen. Kung kanina pumasok kayo dito, malamig kayo, nilalamig kayo, ngayon mawawala ang lamig na yan. Praise the Lord. Amen. Sa aking buhay, ikaw ang number one. Sa aking puso, you're the only one. Problema may dumating, magtitiwala sa'yo. Mga salita mo'y di nagbababago. Come on! Hallelujah! Woo! Ikaw lamang ang pupurihin ko. Ikaw lamang ang sasambahin ko. Panginoon Jesus, ikaw ang buhay ko. Totoo sa aking buhay, ikaw ang number one. Hallelujah! Sa aking buhay, you're the only one. Problema may dumating, nakikiwala sa'yo. Ang salita mo ay ginagbabago. Ikaw lamang. Ikaw lamang ang pupurihin ko. Ikaw lamang, Panginoon, ang sasambahin ko. Panginoong Jesus, ikaw ang buhay ko. Pag-ibig ko'y tunay at totoo. Sa aking buhay, nakikiwala sa'yo. Ang sasalita ay di magbabago. Ikaw lamang! Ikaw lamang ang pupurihin ko. Ikaw lamang ang sasambahin ko.
Panginoong Jesus, ikaw ang buhay ko. Pag-ibig mo'y tunay at totoo.
Haleluya!
Ikaw na kapat, ikaw ang number one sa aking puso.
You're the only one!
You're the only one. Problema may umating, nakikiwala sa'yo. Nasasalita mo ay di na babago. Mga sana ay di na babago. Nasasalita mo ay di na babago.
Mahal na mahal kita, Panginoon!
Mahal na mahal kita, Panginoon.
Come on!
Mahal na mahal kita, Panginoon. Kailan ay di kita'y magpapalit, pagkat sa piling mo'y langit. Mahal na mahal kita, Panginoon.
Mahal na mahal!
Mahal na mahal kita, Panginoon.
Mahal na mahal,
mahal na mahal kita, Panginoon. Kailan ay di kita'y magpapalit, pagkat sa piling mo'y langit. Mahal na mahal kita, Panginoon. Habang buhay, papupurihan ka.
Come on!
Habang buhay,
maglilingkod sa'yo.
Habang buhay, pag-ibig mo sa'yo iaalay.
Mahal na
mahal, mahal na mahal kita, Panginoon. Mahal na mahal, mahal na mahal kita, Panginoon. Kailan may di kita'y pagpapalit, pagkat sa piling mo'y langit. Mahal na mahal kita, mahal na mahal kita, mahal na mahal kita, Panginoon.
Mahal po ba natin ang ating Panginoon?
Amen!
Hala, hindi pa sabay-sabay! Mahal po ba natin si Lord?
Amen!
Amen! Hallelujah! Nasaan ang palakpak? Amen! Hallelujah! Alam po rin nyo, dalawang klase ng palakpak ng tao. Ang palakpak sa tao, ganito. Palakpak sa Diyos. Yan ay para kay Lord. Amen. Pag pinapalakpak ng tao, ganito. Yan. Yan. Kay Lord dito. Palakpak na sosyal. Mga palakpak pala na sosyal, ganun. Praise God. Hallelujah. Whew! Napakabuti po ng ating Panginoon. Napakabuti niya. Sa bawat buhay po natin, may lakas tayo, nandyan. Amen. May mga problema, sa kanya lang pinakakatiwala. So saan ka pa, hindi po ba? So sa oras na ito, ayahan niyo yung mga utang-utang na yan. Amen. Si Lord na magpo-provide niyan. Isipin mo lang si Lord ngayon. At siya nang bahala! Amen! Woo! Kaya sa kagandahan po ng ating Panginoon, yan! Ang misan hindi natin po maisip saan nang gagaling ang mga blessing, hindi po ba? Amen! Kulang-kulang ka ngayon after this service. May blessing. Nabayaran mo na yung mga utang mo, may pera ka pa. Amen! Sa iyong kagandahan, come on, sambahin ka. Gawin po natin panalangin to. Sa iyong kabutihan, purihin ka, Panginoon. Purihin ka, O Diyos, ang ngalan mo.
aking Panginoon, itataas ka namin ngayon at kailanman, magpawalang hanggang sampahin ka sa iyong kagandahan. Ulitin po natin, sa iyong kagandahan. Yes, O Lord. Narito po kami, sumasamba sa iyo, sa iyong kabutihan, Panginoon. Narito kami, magpupuri sa iyo. Yes, O Lord. O Diyos, pangalan mo, Panginoon, itataas ka namin ngayon at kailanman, magpawalang hanggan, sambahin ka sa iyong kagandahan. Sa iyong kagandahan, sambahin ka. Sa iyong kagandahan. Patuloy mo kami pag-isahin sa oras na ito, Panginoon. Ang bawat puso po namin, gawin mong isa. Na sa iyo lang magtitiwala, na sa iyo lang magpupuri. Nagsusumamo, nagpapakumbaba, O Diyos, kami patawarin sa aming sala. Sa mahabahagi sa pagkakampi-kampi, sa kawalan ng pag-ibig sa isa't isa. Nagsusumamo,
nagsusumamo,
nagpapakumbaba,
nagpapakumbaba,
Diyos kami patawarin sa aming sala. Sa pagkakabahagi, sa pagkakampi-kampi, sa wala ng pag-ibig sa isa't isa. Pag-isahin mo ang laman ng aming puso. Pag-isahin mo ang laman ng aming isipan. Bikisin ang iyong pag-ibig, bikisin ang iyong pagmamahal. Jesus, manay ka sa aming buhay.
Pag-isahin mo, Panginoon!
Pag-isahin mo ang
laban
ng aming puso.
Hallelujah!
Pag-isahin mo ang laban ng aming isipan. Bikisin ang iyong pag-ibig, bigisin ang iyong pagmamahal. Jesus, manay ka sa aming buhay.
Pag-isahin mo!
Pag-isahin mo ang laman ng aming puso. Pag-isahin mo ang laman ng aming isipan. Bigisin ang iyong pag-ibig, bigisin ang iyong pagmamahal. Jesus, mahal ka sa aming buhay. Pag-isahin mo ang laman ng aming puso. Pag-isahin mo ang laman ng aming isipan. Bigisin ang iyong pag-ibig, bigisin ang iyong pagmamahal. Jesus, maghari ka sa aming buhay.
Jesus, maghari ka sa aming buhay. Jesus, maghari ka sa aming buhay. Oh, maghari ka. Narito ang bawat puso. Oh, Panginoon, sinisiyasan mo ang bawat isa. Panginoon, purihin ka, dakilain ka sa umagang ito. Ikaw lamang ang aming sasambahin at pupurihin. Ikaw lamang, Panginoon. Ikaw lamang. Ikaw lamang. Hallelujah. Worship the Lord! Oh, worship you, Lord! Oh, worship you, Lord! God, worship you, Lord Jesus!
Salamat po, Panginoon, sa patnubay mo, sa gabay mo sa bawat isa sa amin. Kaya naman, Panginoon, buksan mo po ang bawat pandinig namin sa mga salita mo na aming maririnig. At ito, Panginoon, ay mailagay dito sa bawat puso at maganap. Kaya, Panginoon, pinupuri ka namin, pinasasalamatan. Salamat po sa bawat kamay na pumalakpak, nagpuri sa iyo. Salamat po sa bawat bibig na umawit. Salamat po sa bawat puso na pagpakumbaba. Salamat po sa bawat puso na humingi ng kapatawaran. Salamat po sa bawat isa na naririto. Salamat po sa bawat nilikha mo. Kaya naman, Panginoon, minsan pa, salamat po.
Amen, praise God. Ang sarap pong magpuri kay Lord, di po ba? Amen, praise the Lord. Tunay nga po at sa ating buhay, ang Lord po ang number one. Amen? Pero sa ating puso, He's the only one. Amen? Palakpakan po natin ang ating Panginoon. Amen, praise God. Tunay po, nakapag po ang Panginoon ang siyang number one sa ating buhay, siya po ang nag-iisa sa ating puso, wala pong hadlang, di po ba? Amen, na hindi po tayo makarating po sa kanyang gawain. Amen, hindi po hadlang napagod po tayo sa ating mga trabaho. Amen, hindi naman po hinihingi ng Lord na maghapon po tayo dito, di po ba? It will only take you 2 hours to praise and worship our one true God. Ano pang maging hadlang, di po ba? Hindi hadlang ang labada. Amen, praise the Lord. Hindi hadlang kung ano-ano man ang naroon sa mga BCC or Safe Mall. Ang importante, ang Lord. Amen po ba? Palakpakan po natin ang ating Panginoon. Let us give always the best to the Master. Kaya naman po this time, tinatawagan ko pong ating kapatid na si Brother Sharwin na magbibigay po ng paalala patungkol po sa pagbibigay. Amen.
Amen. Dito na lang ako para makikita ko kayo. Tayo po'y tumayo. At ating buksan ang ating Biblia sa 2 Corinthians chapter 9, verse 7. 2 Corinthians chapter 9, verse 7. And lahat po ba tayo may Bible? Amen. Doon po sa mga walang Bible, kung may cellphone po kayo, pagbili po natin nating cellphone, bumili po tayo ng Bible kasi mas importante po ang Biblia kaysa sa cellphone. Amen. And basahin po natin, 2 Corinthians chapter 9, verse 7. Magbigay ang bawat isa ayon sa ipinasya ng kanyang puso. Huwag mabigat sa loob o dahil kailangan, sapagkat iniibig ng Diyos ang nagbibigay ng masaya. In English, every man according as he purpose in his heart. So, let him give, not grudgingly or of necessity, for God loveth a cheerful giver. Purihin ang Panginoon sa pagbabasa ng kanyang banal na salita. Tayo po'y makakaupo muna. Tunay nga po, no, nasusulat sa ating banal na aklat na tayo magbigay na may kagalakan, na huwag tayong napipilitan. So, kapag nagbigay po tayo, let it be na dahil kailangan tayong mag-offer dito, kaya tayo magbibigay. No, kasi masaya kang maghahandog sa Panginoon. And I remember, no, na sa Biblia, sa Mark chapter 12, verse 41 to 44, may isang matanda na naghulog ng dalawang beles. And ang Panginoon is nalugod. Bakit kaya nalugod ang Panginoon? Brother Sharwin, dalawang beles lang ang inuhulog ng matandang yun. Bakit nalugod ang Panginoon sa kanya? Kasi nagbigay siya na may masaya sa kanyang puso. At the same time, alam nyo ba na yung dalawang beles na yun, yung kung siguro may 200 fils lang siya or 500 fils or 1 dinar. Yung 1 dinar na yun, yun na lang po ang pera sa pitaka niya. Pero inuna niya, ginive niya ng priority ang Panginoon. Kaya nalulugod ang Panginoon kasi He wants to offer this kahit na alam niya na walang-wala siya. Pero truly God, hindi niya tayo pababayaan. Ang mga maya nga, pinapakain niya. What more na tayo na kanyang nilalang. And truly, no, na sa Acts 20 verse 35, it's better to give than to receive. And purihin ang Panginoon. And I want just to make, before ko po tapusin yung message ko, I just want to announce, di ba napakaganda po ng lugar po natin dito sa Ashraf, very much convenient po tayo. And also, yung funds, hindi naman po nanggagaling lang sa ating mga pastor or kung kanino, is nanggagaling po sa atin. So, may mga nag-pledge para sa Ashraf po natin, kaya po nandito po tayo ngayon. And purihin ng Panginoon sa buhay ng bawat isa na nag-pledge. Ang pledge mong yun is every month po nagko-contribute sila. Every month na nandito po tayo sa Ashraf is nagko-contribute po sila. Hindi po sila humihinto sa pag-support po sa ating iglesia. And to those na gusto pong makibahagi po sa pledge na yun dito sa Ashraf, 1 dinar, 2 dinar, basta yung masaya sa puso nyo, it's okay. Di po kailangan na mabigat sa loob nyo yung ibibigay nyo sa church. Yung 1 dinar na yun, malaki nang makocontribute nyo sa church. Don't worry. Ang Lord ang nakakakita nyo, kagaya ng nakita niya sa isang matandang bao. And truly, no, dapat po nating suportahan ang ating iglesia. Kasagat, ito ang ginagamit ng Panginoon na pagpapala para sa atin. And purihin ng Panginoon, tayo po tumayo at manalangin. Heavenly Father, Lord God, Jesus, hallelujah, purihin ka, Panginoon, purihin ka, purihin ang iyong pangalan, Lord God, Jesus, Panginoon. Father, Lord God, nagpapasalamat po kami, Panginoon, sa umagang ito, Panginoon, sa binigyan niyo pong pagkakataon sa amin para i-remind kami, Panginoon, sa aming mga pledges. And na ikaw rin po, Panginoon, ang patuloy na manguna, Panginoon, sa buhay ng bawat isa. Salamat din po sa opportunity, Panginoon, na kami po'y makapagkaloob po sa iyo, Panginoon. Tunay nga po, Panginoon, na ikaw po, Panginoon, patuloy na nagpapala po sa amin, Panginoon. And truly, lahat ng galing po sa amin is ikaw lamang po ang nag-provide nito, Panginoon. Purihin ka, Panginoon. Purihin ang bawat isa, Panginoon, na patuloy na sumusuporta po, Panginoon, sa iyong iglesia. Brother Lord God, continue to bless them. Continue to use them as daluyan na yung pagpapala, Panginoon, sa kanilang buhay, sa iyong iglesia, sa kanilang pamilya, sa lahat ng mga pangangailangan po nila, Panginoon. Ikaw ang manguna at maghari. In your name, Jesus Christ of Nazareth, we pray. Amen.
Amen. Praise God. God bless po sa bawat isa. And again, I would like to reiterate po yung pong nabanggit po ng ating kapatid na si Brother Sherwin. Ano? Totoo po na ito pong lugar po na ating pong kinatatayuan ngayon is nire-rent po ng iglesia. Amen. Hindi po libre ito. But purihin po ang Panginoon sa buhay po ng bawat isa na patuloy po na nandun po yung kagalakan na nakikibahagi po sa gawain. Amen po ba? Ngayon po, for those na nag-commit po before na parang, parang nabigla ata na ganito yung amount na binigay, kung nabibigatan po kayo, you can recommit. Amen po ba? Sabi nga po sa ating message, God loves a cheerful giver. Kung 1 dinar or 2 dinars po yung magaan sa inyo, kung i-share nyo po yan sa gawain ng Panginoon, ang Panginoon po ang magbibless sa inyo. At yung pong mga gusto pong makibahagi sa ministeryong ito, amen, you can approach po Brother Sherwin, you can approach Sister Jeremy and Brother Dennis and Brother Ricky. Sila po yung in-charge po sa pagko-collect po ng ating pong Ashraf Pledge. Amen. Baka isipin po ng iba, ang dami-dami namang mga collection sa church na yan. Hindi po. Amen. Dapat po ang ating pong ang thinking po natin, it is a privilege. Nakakapagbigay ka po sa gawain ng Panginoon. Ibig sabihin, pag may nabibigay ka, ibig sabihin, pinagpapala ka ng Panginoon. Amen po ba? Amen. Kaya naman po, dapat tayo po maging daluyan tayo ng pagpapala sa Panginoon. Amen. Huwag po tayo maging tikom ng kamay dahil ginagamit lang po tayo as stewards ng Lord. Amen po ba? Hindi po bababa ang Panginoon para ibigay niya ang pangangailangan ng iglesyang ito. Kundi tayo-tayo din po ang magsusupport sa gawain. Amen? Amen. Praise God. So sa pagkakataon pong ito, ibibigay ko po kay Brother Marvin na magbibigay po ng papuring awit para sa ating Panginoon.
Kanina pa po ako ninenervyos. First time ko lang pong kakanta. First time ko lang. Amen. Si Jesus lang po ang sa aking buhay. Amen. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Baka po makatulog kayo dyan, ha?
Sikat ng umaga, buhos ng ulan, simoy ng dapit hapon, sinag ng buwan, batis na malinaw, bughaw, kayo ng Panginoon, kung Jesus ng aking buhay, saan man ako bumaling, ika'y naroon, tumalikod man sa'yo, dakilang pag-ibig mo sa akin, tatawag at magpapaalala, ako'y inikilim at siya'y katapat sa ng kaibigan, uyayin ng ina, pangarap na ulila, bisig ng duka, ilaw na may ta, inawalang aba. Gayon ang Panginoon kong Jesus ng aking buhay, saan man ako bumaling, ika'y naroon, tumalik man sa'yo dakilang pag-ibig mo sa akin, tatawag at magpapaalala, ako'y iyong iniiliw at siya'y itatapat sa puso. Saan man ako papaling, ikaw ay naroon, malikod man sa'yo dakilang pag-ibig mo sa akin, tatawag at magpapaalala, ako'y iyong kinikilim at siya'y itatapat sa puso.
Salamat po, Panginoon.
Sa puso po yung message ng awit, ano? Natunay po na dakila po talaga ang pag-ibig ng ating Panginoon. Na kung minsan, tumalikod ka man sa Panginoon, ang Panginoon magpapaalala sa'yo na ginigiliw ka niya. Amen. Kaya sino po tayo para hindi po mabumalik sa presensya ng ating Panginoong Jesus? Amen. Palakpakan po natin ang ating dakilang Diyos. Amen. Siya'y tunay at tapat magpakailanman. Amen. Praise God. At sa pagkakataon din pong ito, tinatawagan ko pong ating isa pang kapatid na nais pong mag-alay ng awit sa ating Panginoon, si Brother Joseph Barrer. Amen. Praise the Lord.
Magandang umaga po sa inyong lahat, lalo na po yung ating mga baguhan po na umattend po ngayong araw na ito. Papuri po sa Panginoon. Ako rin po, attendee rin po ako before, pero nagpapasalamat po ako sa church dahil winelcome po nila ako sa music ministry. Nagpapasalamat po ako sa Panginoon dahil wala naman po tayong ibang reason kung ba't nabubuhay dito kundi ialay ang ating buhay sa ating Panginoon. Salamat po. Sa Diyos ang papuri. Panginoon,
Salamat sa'yo. Inibig mo ang tulad ko. Inalayang buong buhay mo. Upang ako palapit sa'yo, tanggapin mo awiting ito, papurit pagsamba, inaalay sa'yo. Ibigay ko sa iyo itong puso ko, ang buhay ko'y para sa'yo. Papurin pagsamba, kumilos ka sa buhay ko, ako'y mapalapit sa'yo. Tanggapin mo awiting ito, papurit pagsamba, inaalay sa'yo. Ibibigay ko sa iyo itong puso ko, ang buhay ko'y para sa'yo. Papurit pagsamba, kumilos ka sa buhay ko, Panginoon. Papuri po at pagkilos ng Diyos sa ating buhay. Salamat po.
Praise the Lord. Amen and amen. Patapos yung instrument. Hindi po ako kakanta. Amen. Purihin po ang ating Panginoon. Amen. So sa pagkakataon pong ito, alam ko po galak na galak ang ating Panginoon. Amen. Dahil wala akong masyadong nakikitang bakanting upuan. Amen. Glory to God. Amen. Praise the Lord. Amen. Amen and amen. Alam niyo po, kung ilalagay lang po talaga natin sa ating puso, ang ating pong theme, growing deeper, reaching higher. Di po ba? Kung isa po ang dalhin niyo pong soul every week, no? Amen. Magdodoble po tayo eh. Amen po ba? So magkaroon po tayo ng burden na gano'n. Sabi nga po ng message natin ngayon, press toward the mark. Amen. Ano po kaya ang mensahe ni Lord? Excited na po ako. Ibibigay ko na po sa kanyang messenger. Tinatawagan ko na po si Pastor Christopher Aguilar. Amen.
Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Can you hear me from the back? No. Praise God. Praise Jesus. Are you blessed, church? Yes. Are you blessed, church? Yes. Amen. So I have to put my mouth in this mic. just instead, okay. May I request the congregation to please stand and let's open our Bible in the book of Philippians chapter number 3. But we will start in verse 13 to 14. Are you with me, church?
Yes.
Okay, yung mga walang Bible, you can just browse our screen for tonight or for today. The Bible says in Philippians chapter 3, verse 13 to 14. By the way, Paul wrote this wonderful verse in the Bible. And it mentioned, "Brethren, I count not myself to have apprehended, but this one thing I do." I was surprised when I was reading this Bible verse because Paul was telling one thing, but he mentioned three things. Amen. But if you try to analyze it, the Word of God is quick and powerful and it's giving us a message for today. He said, but this one thing, not something, not all things, but one thing I do. Number one, forgetting those things which are behind. Amen. And reaching forth unto those things which are before. Amen. Wow. Ang ganda, ano po? Sa Tagalog. Gusto natin kalimutan yung kahapon. Amen. Let's just forget about yesterday. Amen. Yesterday, it's finished. Kalas. Ams. Kalas. One thing I do, forgetting those things which are behind and reaching forth unto those things which are before. I press toward the mark, ang sabi po ni Paul, for the prize of the high calling of God in Christ Jesus. Amen. Let's give him a hand clap of praise. Come on, church. Let's give him a hand clap of praise. Let's worship the Lord in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Let's worship him in the beauty of his holiness. In his name. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Heavenly Father, Lord God, Jesus, we worship you and we glorify your name. We thank you, Father God, Lord Jesus, for the privilege, for the opportunity to worship you in spirit and in truth. We do believe, Father God, Lord, that you brought us here because you have a purpose. Amen. Let everyone, O Lord God Jesus, that has breath, worship you and glorify your name. Because we do believe, Father God, Lord Jesus, in the book of Revelation, chapter number 4, verse 2, that there's only one throne in heaven, and we will meet you face to face, O Lord God Almighty. And that we will meet you, O Lord God Jesus, with your holy presence. Right now, Father God, Lord, let your anointing be upon me, O Lord God. Let the hearers of the word, O Lord God Jesus, meditate your words. And we do believe, Father God, Lord, that you will not allow them to leave this place, Lord. You will continue to do wonders and miracles in their lives. We do believe, Father God, Lord Jesus, at the end of this service, Lord, we will press more forward to the mark. And thank you, Father God, Lord, for bringing us our brethren for the first time from China, from Bahrain, from the Philippines, O Lord God Jesus, and to all sisters and brothers who are watching right now live from California, in Oman, in Qatar, in Saudi Arabia, in the Philippines. Lord God Jesus, let your words be upon us. Amen. Thank you, Father God, for this wonderful opportunity. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen, amen, amen and amen. Praise the Lord. Amen. The world says, if you were born gay, you will die gay. The world says. But the word of God says, every day, God is giving us a chance to live with hope. Amen. The world says, if you were born poor, you will die poor. If your parents are uneducated, you will be uneducated. But the word says, no. The world says, if you are a sinner, you will die as a sinner. But the Word of God says, He can take you from darkness and He can bring you into His marvelous light. And that's the Word of God. Amen. The God of this world is trying to deceive as many as He could. Amen. He always emphasized that wala ka ng silbi. You are hopeless. You are nothing. You cannot do anything. But remember, you have only one life to live in this earth. Only one life. There's no other life after this. Amen. You cannot go back ano po, where you belong. There's only two destinations that we have. That is in heaven and in hell. Amen. Are you prepared to face those destinations right now? If God will be here and you will meet Him, what will you say? Are you ready to meet Him? Amen. Are you ready to meet Him or gusto mo pumunta sa baba, sa impyerno? Bakit sa baba? Amen. And that's the world says. The world says, you are hopeless. Wala ka ng chance. You are living this world as if nothing. Every day, you're struggling in this life. You wake up in the morning, take a bath, go to your work. At the end of the day, go home and then sleep. It's a routine. Amen. And there's no life after that. You are being hooked by this world because you don't know your purpose in this life. But if God will reveal to us right now, amen, do not allow yourselves to leave this place that you don't know what's the purpose behind this called life. Huwag po kayong uuwi, amen, that you don't understand why you are still breathing, why you are still here existing, why still God is giving you a chance because there is hope. And the Paul, it was written 2 years ago, he mentioned that I count not myself to have apprehended, but this one thing I do, forgetting those things which are behind. Amen. Because a lot of people, they cannot move in this life because of their past. Amen. Some people, they are hiding themselves because they cannot move on. Amen. They are still relying. Amen. They are still meditating what happened yesterday. When in fact, if you can see your clock, it's moving forward, not backward. Amen. Amen. So try to think of it, brothers and sisters, there's hope in God. And God is giving us a second chance. God is giving us a second chance. Amen. Kaya nga po, ano man po nangyari sa buhay mo yesterday? What happened in your life last year, last month? Amen. Last 10 years? Forget about those things. Amen. We are looking forward for tomorrow. Amen. Because God is waiting for you right now to give you a better end. God is giving you a chance so that you will realize ang sarap po palang mabuhay sa mundo. It's nice to be here in the world, brothers and sisters. Amen. With Jesus. Amen. Amen. So the Bible says in the book of 2 Corinthians chapter number 5, verse 17, therefore, if any man be in Christ, forget about what happened yesterday. Kung meron kang kinakasama lalaki na ayaw ng Panginoon sa'yo, forget about yesterday. You made a big mistakes in your life, forget about yesterday. God is telling you right now, if you be in Christ, if anyone be in Christ, he is a new creature. Irregardless what you did last night, irregardless what you did yesterday, irregardless what you did last week, amen, God is not, amen, pleased sa ano po nangyari sa'yo. That's why God is giving you today. That's why this is called present, right? Because it's a gift from God. Amen. And today is what, January 27, 2017? Later, this is history, right, Brother Eunice? We cannot go back. Tomorrow, this day is history. So, your decision in life today, it will matter tomorrow. Amen. It will matter tomorrow, brothers and sisters. Kaya if I were you, if you are still living in your yesteryears, amen. You are still bombarding your life. I did this, I do that, I don't have any hope. Wala akong ginawa, kundi, no. It's time for you to wake up and says, Lord, I do believe that if any man be in Christ, I am a new creature. All things, sabihin mo nga sa katabi mo, all things are passed away. Behold, all things are become new. Wow! And that's a promise. And that's a promise. Amen. That's why if you're still living in yesterday, you cannot move forward. Amen. You cannot move forward. But, you know, brothers and sisters, you have the power within yourself to move forward. Do you believe that? Do you believe that? It's not because of your mom and dad that you can move forward. It's not because the people around you can move forward. God gave you this power in yourself. That if you don't want to live in yesteryears, in yesterday's dilemma in your life, it's time for you today to move, to wake up and step, amen, out whatever anuman pong dilemma na meron ka. I know some of you until now, you are still struggling in your life. You cannot move forward because of your yesterday. Amen. But the Bible says, if anyone is in Christ, you are a new creature. Ano man po ang nangyari yesterday, God is not interested, by the way, of what happened to you yesterday. God is not interested what happened, what you did last night, what you did yesterday. God is interested, what is your decision today after hearing this message? Amen. Amen. Because the Bible says in the book of Colossians 1:13, who had delivered us from the power of darkness? Who delivered us? God Himself. Amen. Do you know, brothers and sisters, God brought you here because He has a purpose. Last night, He's already talking to you. And somebody's invited you right now because God told him to invite you. Amen. Amen. And don't sit. Kung nasan kayo ngayon, it was already reserved since last night. Because God is talking to you right now because He has a purpose. Amen. Kung hindi pa yung kayo naniniwala, I cannot convince you, but I'm telling you, brothers and sisters, everything happens for a reason. Amen. For the first time, we saw each other, may plano po ang Panginoon. Amen. Amen. Because God doesn't want us to live in darkness. Amen. Ayaw ng Panginoon na nahihirapan ka. Do you know how life in darkness? No life at all. If you are living in darkness without light, brothers and sisters, what happened? In Bahrain, Brother Eunice, vitamin D deficiency is huge. It's rampant. It's rampant. You know, vitamin D deficiency is one of the causes of diabetes, osteoporosis, problem of hormonal imbalances. Amen. That's why a lot of Bahrainis, we are convincing them to take at least 50,000 international units of vitamin D at least once a week. Amen. For 6 to 8 weeks. Amen. Living in darkness, walang life. And all of us, when we were in grade school, right? The plant need sunlight to produce chlorophyll, right? Review me, teacher. Girly. So we need light para ma-sustain po yung ating life. Amen. Look at the people in North Pole. In North Pole, some of them, they cannot leave. You know, that's why some of them, they are migrating in other parts of the world because there's no sunlight. Amen. And without sunlight, there's no photosynthesis. You know, babalik tayo sa ating pong grade school. Amen. Because God doesn't want us to live in darkness. Amen. So if your life seems to be in darkness today or yesterday, God is not interested for you. Amen. To dwell on the past. God is interested for you. Or to you right now, kung ano po yung magiging decision mo. Because God Himself delivered us from the power of darkness and had translated us into the kingdom of His dear Son, in whom we have redemption through His blood, even the forgiveness of sins. Amen. So stop bombarding yourself. Kung ano man po yung nangyari yesterday, forget about it. Amen. God is giving us a chance right now. God is giving you hope right now. Amen. Do you know, church, the best miracle that happened in one's life is not because God healed you from your sickness. No. The best miracle that happened to you when you accepted Him as your Lord and Savior and you changed your mind from darkness into His marvelous light. Amen. Yun po ang greatest miracle na nangyayari sa buhay natin. The greatest miracle is not because God is being blessed, ano po, you with abundant of materials in this life. No, that's not. Amen. Or maybe you had a sicknesses or illness and God healed you. Yun na po yung wonders and miracles na pinag-uusapan. No, it's not. The miracle that God is always telling us, when you accepted Him, amen, and you are living in darkness, now God pulled you out from darkness and He brought you into His marvelous light. That is the wonderful miracle na nangyari sa atin.
Amen.
Right?
Amen.
And you know what miracle happened today? Maybe yesterday, last week, last month, you don't even whisper or you didn't even tell the name of Jesus sa buhay mo. You don't even close your eyes to pray. But now, something happened to your life. I'm just, you know, I'm observing you today, amen, that you close your eyes and you're talking to Him and you are raising. That's the best miracle na nangyayari sa iyo. Amen. And that's the best miracle. Amen. That you will encounter the King of Kings and Lord of Lords. Amen. That you will encounter the King of Kings and Lord of Lords. In 1 John 4:4, ang sabi po ng Panginoon, ye are of God, little children, and have overcome them. Amen. So if there's something, pressure in your life that is bombarding you, ano po, or something like pulling you out, amen, from your yesteryears, amen, I'm telling you, if you have Jesus in your heart, if you have God in your heart, sabi po, because greater is He that is in you than he that is in the world. Amen. If you want God, brothers and sisters, nobody can stop you going to a trap right now. Amen. Maybe your alarm clock, you turn it off, amen. Distraction po yan, right? Right? Or maybe one of your friends called you, oh, brother, sister, we have sale right now. Have you been in Bahrain shop near Bahrain Bay? They have a huge sale right now. It's Friday. Come on, let's go out. And then, if you are weak, kapag mahina ka, kapag may spirit that dwelleth in you, that is greater, amen, and you don't want to go to the church, patay ka na. Ay, oo nga. Ano po? Ano mangyayari? You'll just waste your time, waste your money. At the end of the day, wala ka narinig ng Word of God. Amen. And this is routine right now. This is routine. Satan is trying to deceive ang mga tao. They don't want you to go to the church. Satan doesn't want you to go to the church to worship God. Why? Because the moment that you worship God, you will have a relationship to Him. Amen. And Satan is not happy at all. Because you know, Satan is trying to pull you out because he is not selfish. 100% is going to hell. I'm telling you, it is written in Bible. God told Satan that he's going to hell. So, si Satan, brothers and sister, gusto po niyang may kasama doon. Amen. Sister Jane, gusto mong kasama? Nobody wants to go to hell. Who among you wants to go to the hell? Sino pong gustong pumunta sa hell right now? Raise your hand. Nobody. Walang crazy people or only crazy people will admit that they want to go to hell. Right, Brother Shane? Nobody wants to go to hell. But you have to do something if you want to go to heaven.
Amen.
You have to do something. Amen. Ang sabi nga sa Romans, the wages of sin is death. Meaning, wages, meaning pinagtatrabawan po ang kasalanan. Right? You are working on it. Amen? Kaya nga, yung wages ng sin is death. But the gift of God is eternal life.
Amen.
So you have to choose which path you want to go right now. If you want to go to hell, you can do whatever you want. Don't attend the church. Don't listen to the word of God. Because you don't want, you are not interested in God. Right? So go to hell. But nobody will admit that. I want to go to hell. I want to go to heaven. But the mere fact that you want to go to heaven, you have to do something about it. Right? So right now, if you are still in bondage of sin, amen, God is not interested after hearing this message. Kung ano man pong kasalanan meron ka. I can feel right now, some of you are still confused in this cold life. Amen. But you have to try to figure it out before we will leave this place. Amen. Because God will not allow you to leave this place hanggang ngayon, hanging pa rin ang perception mo sa buhay. Amen. We have to analyze our life. We have to press the mark. You have to know what goal you have in this life. Amen. You have to know your enemy in this so-called life. Amen.
You have to know the enemy. You cannot go in a battle without knowing yung mga secrets ng enemy mo. Amen? If you have some sicknesses, you have to know it, brothers and sisters. Amen? One man back, I have a patient, Brother Eunice, Bahrain. We are working in Alba. So as a physician, as a doctor, I'm always seeing this patient, ano po. But the problem is, we have this patient, is quite a little bit, you know, huge. And he is frequently visited us because of sick leave. Amen. He's always malingering. He's always telling us, Doctor, I have ankle pain. I cannot work. You know, I cannot move. We did x-rays. We did MRI. Everything normal. Amen. And then it came to a point that he attended one of our doctors, Dr. Omer. Amen. And he's still complaining of ankle pain. Ang sabi po ni Dr. Omer, you know what's your problem? What's my problem, doctor? Because your weight is, obesity is giving you the problem. And he was upset. How dare you, doctor? It's not my weight. Sabi niya, it's not my weight. Come on. You have to treat my ankle. This is my personal life. You don't have to embarrass my personal life. Amen. You are just a doctor. So they have a clash between them. Okay. So, in short, he was driven out. So the next day, he visited me. He said, I don't want to go to this doctor because, you know, he's trying to tell me about my weight. This is my personal doctor. I hate somebody telling me these things. Okay, so what's your problem? So I dig the history. This guy is having problem for the past 2 weeks, having fever on and off, fever on and off, fever on and off, fever on and off. It took him 1 month, fever on and off. Amen. I sent him to American Mission. I sent him to Salmania. I went to Al-Kindi. I sent him to Ibn al-Nafis. Name it, all the institutions in Bahrain, they know him. They did x-rays. They did everything. They found nothing. Amen. Now, it's time for me to pray. Because every now and then, this patient is coming in my room and he's telling me, doctor, I'm still having fever. And I can't see. You know, the temperature is always from 38 to 39 degrees centigrade. I check everything, brothers and sisters. Name it. I check all the holes sa kanyang buhay. Amen. Nothing. I cannot see anything. Is WBC is normal. His laboratories are normal. Everything is normal. Chest x-ray is normal. CRP is normal. Everything. No, by the way, CRP is a little bit high. So, Lord, I ask the Lord to give me wisdom. Lord God, I don't know what to do. I'm now at the end of my rope. What will I say to this patient? One time he visited me. Still, he's having fever. Just recently, 1 month. I mean, 1 week back. I palpated. He has a big lymph nodes here in the right cervical area. I told him, this is something new to you. Yeah, doctor. Then I palpated. Yes, it's a mass. It's a huge mass. Because you cannot even see it because it's a little bit obese, you know. Medyo mataba siya. So I was short neck. I was trying, you know, like, to be honest, difficulty assessing him. But when I palpated, I told him, you have to do CT scan. And we did a fine needle aspiration. We have to remove fine aspiration so that at least we can see. You know, there are certain things in life that we cannot see from our naked eye. Amen? There are certain diseases that doctors not even know what's going on. So what happened? I referred him to Al-Kindi, and then they did aspiration. So they put the needle, and then they aspirate. And then, because Al-Kindi is a private hospital, so all the bloods and everything, they were sent to Salmania. And you know what happened? 3 days back, they called him. And then they informed me, doctor, your patient has TB. Has TB. Tuberculosis. So I met him yesterday. I asked him, brother, you have TB. And you know how many medications they gave? Rifampicin, isoniazid, pyrabitamol, ethambutol, for 2 months, and then we will extend at least 6 months. See, with that signs and symptoms of fever alone, his life became miserable. Right? For all his life, he was just complaining of ankle pain, ankle pain, ankle pain, and fever, ankle pain, ankle pain, and fever. And then I dig the history, and I found out that they have a nanny, a utopian nanny, was recently diagnosed with pulmonary tuberculosis. Immediately, they called him from Salmania, and then they sent her home after treatment. They sent her home. So she was exposed, to be honest, he was exposed with this TB illness. Amen. But nobody knows. Nobody knows. Amen. So that's why, brothers and sisters, sometimes, if you will not tell the truth, if you will not accept the fact that you are having this problem in your life, even your pastor cannot help your problem. Amen. If you are pressing the mark and we don't know the enemy that lies behind your life, we cannot do anything about it. And then I dig history. Sister Tina, he had cough for the past 2 months. He did not even mention. He had fever at night. He had chills. He had rigors during at night fever. And he's obese. My goodness. Lahat po ng mga TB ata, TB patients sa atin, mukhang kalansay, ano? Nobody will talk about it. Amen. But God, right now, let's put it in spiritual things. Let's put it in spiritual things. If anything, or if anyone here, still, you have the signs and symptoms of sicknesses of sin, that you are still hiding, amen, it will become worse. Amen. There are certain things in life, sometimes tinatago po natin yan, kinoconceal natin yan, yung mga kasalanan. We are trying to hide those sins. Amen. We cannot even say to the doctors, or we cannot say to your pastors. Like as for doctors, amen, it's not prudent to go to the clinic, and I will ask you, what's your problem? The reason why I came in, I have a problem. You have to know what's my problem, right? You are a doctor. There are certain people like that. No. To be honest, 85% of what you are going to say to your doctor, 85% of my diagnosis will rely on what you are saying. So, 15%, I will just confirm, I will just take blood and everything, I will just do x-rays, 15% of my diagnosis. But 85% kung ano po yung sinasabi mo. Right? Amen? History. This is the most important thing. So, yung ano yung history mo, brothers and sisters? Ano yung history mo? Because there are a lot of people, you know, they are playing around. They are going to the doctor, what is your problem? I have this, I have that, I have this, I have that. Sometimes it's not related. Amen. Just focus. You know what's your problem right now. You know from the very start that you step in this room, God is talking to you right now. Meron po tayong mga kasalanan na tinatago na hindi po natin may share ito kahit kanino man. Amen. But at the end of the day, once it becomes worse, hindi na natin may babalik yung kahapon. Amen. Right? You cannot go back yesterday. That's why God wants you to be set free right now. God wants you to be set free. Ano man po ang ginagawa natin that you are struggling right now, it's time for you to be true and to be honest. Because at the end of the day, nobody can help you but yourself. Nobody can help you but yourself. If you are struggling in life until now, amen, you cannot go to the mark. You cannot press forward to the mark because of your yesteryears, from your problems, from your struggles in life yesterday, amen. You cannot move on. Wala pong mangyayari sa'yo. You will just, what? Delaying everything. Amen. Ano mangyayari? Pag malaki ng problema, dun pa lang. Amen. Right? Again, I'm just, you know, telling you stories in a sense that sometimes we have to put ourselves sa mga story na ito. Amen. When I work in BDF, Tawara, I have a frequent visitors there. Sabi ko nga sa BDF, kung meron lang tayong frequent flyer dito, like Gulfair. You know, frequent flyer in Gulfair. They have some, you know, they have some consolation, right? I'm telling the management, why don't we have some frequent visitors in the hospital? Then we will give them one discounted, or we will give them 1 month supply of Dulcolax. O kaya mga one, you know Dulcolax, this is a laxatives, you know? Ifi imsak, yan ni Mafi Kuruj. You have to drink this Dulcolax, you know. I have a patient in which is diabetic. He's diabetic. Yung sugar niya talagang 400. Hemoglobin A1C niya is 12, 11, 12, 11. but still is denying, no, doctor, I'm still okay. I don't feel anything, doctor. I'm still fine. See, I do exercise. I do everything. Mabi muskila, habibi. Okay. The problem is, if you will not accept that you are diabetic and you are not doing anything about it, kalas, I saw him one time, you know, with crutches. Sino pi muskila? Doctor, fi muskila. What problem? Now, he lost his foot. Amputated. See? If you will not accept from yourself that you need help, nobody will help you. Nobody will help you. You cannot press toward the mark. Amen. You are still trying to deny the fact that you need help. You need God. It's up to you. It's up to you. Amen. In James 4:7, the Bible said, you have to submit yourselves, therefore, to God. Amen. This is only the thing that you have to do. Submit yourself to God. Submit yourself to God. Resist the devil. Resist the devil. And he will flee from you. Resist the devil and he will flee from you. Amen. You should know your enemy, brother. Amen. Because you cannot win the battle called life if you don't know your enemy. Amen. So kung ang enemy mo is katamaran, amen, hindi ka nag-aate ng mga gawain ng church, that's a struggle. That's a struggle. That's a struggle. Amen. If you don't know the enemy, amen, you will still stuck in this life. Ah, hindi po kayo mag-grow. Hanggang ngayon, mananatili kayong bata sa spiritual. You should know the enemy. Lasem. Amen. Sa aming buhay, last week, you know how we struggle? Our little Faith. Si Faith, our daughter, she had some viral infection. One night, she was coughing like, you know, croupical. Barky sounds. So I know the enemy. I know her. Amen. So I told my wife, oh my God, Mr. Krupp visited us in this room. And then she started to having some high-grade fever. So we're just, you know, okay, everything is fine because we know the enemy. We will start dexamethasone. I have dexamethasone at home. So the following day, she improved because we know the enemy. And then she started coughing. She is having retraction. You know, your normal breathing should be in the chest, but she's breathing in the abdomen. Amen. And she's having high-grade fever. So I'm, you know, as a doctor, I have to think a lot of diseases. Amen. Hindi lang po pwedeng, hindi po ba, pagka ubo lang yan. Ano lang yan, virus yan. Amen. But you have to find out what's the problem. It came to a point that Sunday early morning, we woke up at around 1 o'clock in the morning, and she's grunting. Imagine, 3-year-old grunting. This is a big no-no for us doctors. We don't want children to grunt. Amen. So what happened early in the morning, I called Alba. I told him I cannot go because my priority is my daughter. So we will go to the hospital right now. You know, I'm going to the hospital because it doesn't mean that I don't know what I'm going, what I'm trying to do. I want chest x-ray. I don't have chest x-ray at home. Sino may chest x-ray sa bahay dito? Mafi, right? Because I want to make sure that my enemy is still there and I'm still doing my best. Amen. Toward the mark. Toward the mark. So what happened? When I saw the x-ray, we did the x-ray and then the technician told me, doctor, the x-ray is available. When I saw it, finish. I'm done. This virus, we can knock him out because we know the enemy. Amen. Kaya if you are still trying to conceal some things in your life that you are not exposed, you are in a big trouble. God cannot help you with your problems. Alatul yan, if your life is still routine, ganun po ang buhay mo, amen, you are still living in a lie. You are still living, hindi naman mo asawa, kinakasama mo, that's a lie. Eh, sinasabi mo, friends lang kami, pastor, friends lang kami, we're like this, we're like that, friends lang kami, no string attached. If you're still living in lie, God will not set you free. God will never set you free. Amen. Amen po ba? I have a friend just came from Dubai. He was telling me, in Dubai, Habibi, muskila yan eh. At sa Dubai, talaga pong matindi. Di ba, may pupunta ng Dubai? Matindi ang buhay doon sa Dubai. Amen. Because, you know, their life there is really miserable. Ang bahay doon, magkano, Sister Mirna, magkano po yung mga bahay doon? 100 BD? No. Isang room? Magkano, Pastor Marvin? 370 BD? One room? One small room? So what they are doing right now? Ginagawa nilang mga four in one room. Four in one room. Six people in one room. Wow. Six people in one room. You know? And then doon na nagkakaroon ng mga immorality. Amen. Because they are saving money. Ang problema, yun. Ayaw ko na. Matanda na kayo. Alam niyo na yung iniisip ko. So until now, if you're still struggling this life, brothers and sisters, nobody can help you. Okay, are you ready, church? Oh my God, I'm just starting. Are you here with me? I'm just starting the message. Amen. But I know that God will give us wisdom. You know, Satan would like for you to think that you can change. Right? Let's put in the scenario. Let's put your shoes in this so-called life. May problema kayo. If you will not accept the fact that you have problem, then there's no room for you to change. Right? If you don't accept that you need God, you're still living in a lie. So, what's kailangan? Amen. Nobody will help you. Satan would like for you to think that you can change. It doesn't matter what you have done, I'm telling you right now, or where you have been. Jesus Christ can deliver you and break the chains of bondage in your life. Jesus is the answer. Amen. If you don't know the answer, bakit ngayon ang buhay mo miserable, your life is still miserable, there is one answer. Jesus Christ is the answer. Amen. Believe it or not, Jesus Christ is the answer. Amen. Believe it or not, Jesus Christ is the answer. Amen. We're not playing around in this church. We're not playing around in this church. You are not attending the church because you want to listen to the Word of God. No! You are in this church because you want to be changed by God. Amen. This is not a New Year's resolution anymore. Amen. We're almost past approaching February, brothers and sisters. This is not New Year's resolution. What I'm trying to say is take the opportunity, take the chance that once you step in this church, brothers and sisters, your life will change. Not only this week, not only next week, but if you want to be changed, you will be changed for the rest of your life. Amen. Are you ready, church? Amen. Madali lang po ito. Amen. I preached this about the gatherings. Amen. How many times? Four times, five times in this church. But it was so striking last Tuesday because we have some new birth experience. We're talking about new birth experience. And suddenly, God just spoke to me and then tell about these gatherings. You know, this guy, I don't know if you believe in exorcism. You believe in exorcism, Eunice? Exorcism, that spirit, you know, spirit that can go to a person's body. Tina, do you know that? Jin, yani. I don't know if you experienced that some spirits that they can go in one's body and they will have this possession and everything, you know. I do believe that. One time, I experienced it. Not only in during my medical years, I experienced it even here in Owa. Where is Brother Ricky? Brother Ricky, where are you? Right? Pastor Marvin. In Owa. In sa atin pong embassy. One day, they called us. You know why they called us? Because somebody was possessed. May na-possess. Talagang, exorcism. You know, it's really scary. So they called one of the church pastor in Bahrain. Big church, huh? Big church. And then this pastor said, no, they rejected the call. You know why? Kasi po, pastor, nung tinawag ako, kasi po, hindi daw po sila naka-fasting. So they were not ready. So they called us. So we came to Owa, you know, we visited. And it's true. Imagine, she was in double deck. Pastor Marby, you still remember Brother Ricky? She was like this, you know. And then all of us, you know, we were shocked because this woman, brothers and sisters, she was about to fall. She was about to fall, you know, like 45 angels. And all of us were shocked because she returned back to normal. Pangulog na siya talagang, I don't know what type of spirit. And we saw really she did a lot of things in this in this office, you know. She broke the glasses, she broke everything, you know. It's totally messed up. Oh, wow. You cannot even imagine. And all of them, they were afraid. They were afraid. But God, you know, we prayed for her and God set her free. Ginamit po ang church na ito. God set her free. The following week, she was attending our congregation. Amen. Because of what? Because of God. Because of Jesus. Amen. Now, if you believe on those aspects, brothers and sisters, Satan can do that thing to you. If you're not sensitive enough, Satan can mess your life. Amen. Can mess your life. Do you believe that? May mga spirit po na hindi natin nakikita. May mga spirit of poverty, spirit of adultery, spirit of fornication, spirit of lawlessness, spirit, name it. Those are spirits that are trying to deceive you, trying to tell you ano po, that you are a loser. Amen. Now, let's move. In Mark chapter 5, the Bible says, Jesus, they came to the other side of the sea, to the country of the Gadarenes. So, I'm always telling this church that if Jesus Christ is going to one place, he's not going because he has purposeless. Amen. He's going because God will do some wonders and miracles in that place. So, Jesus and his disciples went to the Gadarenes. If you go back in your Bible, in the book of Joshua, chapter number 22, the children of Israel were getting ready to cross the Jordan River. It was at this point that the tribes of Reuben, Gad, and half of the tribe of Manasseh decided not to cross over the Jordan, choosing instead to settle the area known in Mark 5 as Gadara. This is Lipi po ni Gad. Okay, during their journey going to the Jordan River, ito pong Reuben, Gad, and half of the tribe of Manasseh, they don't want to go to pass that Jordan. So what happened? This is Gadara. Okay, just for your information. Okay, they don't want Reuben, si Gad, and half of the Manasseh, they don't want to go with them in Jordan River. So they make the decision to separate themselves from the tabernacle in the presence of God. So it's their decision. They don't want to go to the Jordan River. It's their problem. Amen. They told Joshua that they would remember the ordinances of God and to prove that they would establish an altar that they called Ed. The purpose of this altar was not sacrifice, but for remembrance. So when you get away from an altar of sacrifice and are separated from the presence of God, you will soon forget about some of the things you choose to be consecrated from. Right? Amen? In Tagalog, kapag ka hindi na po kayo nagpatuloy na lumakad sa presensya ng Panginoon, you will lose a lot of things. And you will forget a lot of things in this belief. Amen? Amen? Marami akong kilala ngayon. They go, they separate their ways sa church na ito. Now, their life, anong nangyayari? Became miserable. Amen. Now, we need to get into the presence of the Lord. We need to get into the presence of the Lord. Amen. When you separate yourself from the church, it won't be long before compromise sets in and people begin to bound again by the things that they had previously been delivered from. Amen. Read Luke chapter number 11. Ang sabi po ng Bible, if one spirit umalis sa katawan mo, and it will come back, mag-aakay po yan ng 7 devils. Amen. To ruin your life. Kaya yung mga nag-backslide right now, how many demons you are having? 7 demons ang meron kayo. 7 demons. Amen. I'm telling you. Walang masaya sa umalis sa church ng Panginoon. I'm not threatening you. I'm not giving you this fear. But I'm telling you the truth. Amen. Sa church, kapag umalis ka, the devil is trying to give a lot of problems sa iyong buhay. Now, sino gusto pong nakatali? Sino gusto ditong makulong? Who among you wants to go to the prison right now? Nobody, right? But in this Bible verse, in verse 2, the Bible says, and when he had come out of the boat, immediately there met him out of the tombs a man with an unclean spirit. So Jesus, amen, he encountered one man with unclean spirit. Meron po siyang kakaibang spirito. And you know what? This guy is living in tomb. Sa cementerio. Who likes to live in tomb? You know what is the tomb, Brother Eunice? cemetery where the dead people, they buried them. Nobody would like to stay there. But this guy, because he was with an unclean spirit, he stayed there for his entire life. Amen. He was dwelling among the tombs and no one could bind him, not even with chains. So he's out of his mind. Amen. Nobody wants to go to cemetery. Amen. Wala pong gusto. Right? Kaya nga po, if you like to go alone, right? Those people, I just want to tell you some stories. Those people who left this church, they are living in miserable life. Naging loner sila, Sister Jane. And always they love to hear radio station. Lalo na pag ang favorite song nila yung Lonely, I'm Mr. Lonely, I have nobody. Come on, mga batang 80s, you know this song? Huh? On my own, I am a soldier, a lonely soldier, right? Tama. If you are living in lies, if you are living in sin, you want to be alone, right? Ayaw nyo yung mga nagbobombard sa'yo. Nobody, you don't want people tell you that you are doing this, you are doing that. As much as possible, you just want to stay in one place, close your door, close the light, and then, lonely. You don't even want to go to the church. And this is what happened to him. They bind him, amen, and not even chains. Because he had often been bound with shackles and chains, and the chains had been pulled apart by him, and the shackles broken pieces, neither could anyone tame him. Walang makakapag-stop sa kanya. That's why people, they prepare him to stay in the cemetery with the tombs. Amen. This is the society is doing. Whenever they hear him, you know, just see this face. Can you just take a quick look with your neighbor right now? Look if they look like this. Come on. With chains, sadness, depression, anxiety. Sino po nakakaranas nito? Come on, church. Be honest. Sino nakakaranas dito? Last Tuesday, I was surprised. I was surprised. Somebody wants to commit suicide. Wow. By the way, once in my life, I live in the cemetery. Once in my life, I live in the cemetery. You know, way back in 1993, when I discovered my dad, si Pastor Esting, he was not yet pastor, my dad, he was living with another girl, another woman. Amen. Ako po ang nakakita dito sa Bahrain. Wow! I was sleeping. And then my dad and this woman, you know, like, come on. Every night I was crying. I was only 15 years old. And I couldn't imagine, you know, my dad is playing around. And my dad said, shh. Don't tell your mom. Because I obey my dad. I love him so much. It came to a point that I was living in cemetery. Instead, I will take my medtech po. Dapat ang aking, although I'm a medtech, dapat sa UST ako magme-medtech. But because I want to live alone, I went to Baguio one day. And then, nag-apply ako sa St. Louis University. And history na. Doon na ako nag-start. I was living in lies. I was living with San Miguel Beer. Every day. Grande, Abdullah. You don't know Grande? Mafi Grande here in Bahrain, la? Only Aine. I know only Aine can you know. San Miguel Beer. Oh my God. Name it. I tried taking Red Horse. Sinisipa ako. But just to make things clear, you know, I did not take drugs. You can check my blood. I did not take drugs. I smoke. I smoke not marijuana, I smoke the regular one. I was living in cemetery. And this guy, brothers and sisters, always night and day, he was in the mountains and in the tombs, crying out and cutting himself with stones. Oh! Nobody cares, di ba? Pagka a loner ka, pag may ginagawa kang kasalanan, because nobody will amen. Even your loved ones, they will not tell you, tama yung ginagawa mo, sis. Makiabibi ka sa kanya. Maraming datong yan. Wala. Nobody. sira ulong nanay yun. Sorry ha, but I'm telling you, walang magulang na sasabing tama ang ginagawa mo anak dahil you are making mistakes. Kapag hindi ka pinapalo ng mga magulang mo, that means hindi kayo mahal ng mga magulang mo. Makinig kayo mga magulang. Kapag yung mga anak niyo gumagawa ng kasalanan and you are trying to tell them, yes, it's okay, they will go to hell with you. God loves, He chased those He loved. Pinapalo ng Panginoon kanyang mga iniibig. Amen. Right? Are you happy living in this so-called life na ganito? Patago? Pag nakikita mo yung asawa niya, Habibi, your wife, your wife, your wife! Woo! It's so funny, but at least, nalalaman po natin what's going wrong. Amen. I still have 10 minutes left. Are you with me, church? Yes. And always night and day, He was in the mountains and in the tombs crying out and cutting Himself. I don't know what pain, kung ano yung pain na meron siya. He want to end up his life. He want to commit suicide. Amen. He was with fetters and chains. Amen. Nobody wants him. His loved ones ignore him. They don't even send him a Valentine's card. Diba? Malapit ng Valentine's card, huh? He was all alone by himself. Nobody cares. Nobody gave him some food. Nobody visited him. He was just staying in tomb in cemetery all alone by himself. Amen. Nakaka-relate ka ba? Huh? Pag gumagawa tayo ng kasalanan, we are doing some mistakes, our family will never, 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 never tolerate you. Amen. And then, here you are. Hindi ako mahal ng mga magulang ko, mga kapatid ko, binabalaan ako. Hindi ako binibisita. We'll make the problem. You did the problem. You put yourself in a cemetery. Amen. So that's the problem. Now, the thing is, when he saw Jesus from afar, makinig kayo. Makinig kayo. Every day, I don't know how long, I don't know how many nights, how many months, how many years, he was there crying every day. He was cutting himself, I want to kill myself. Ay, hindi pa matalas. Sige. How many of you try to destroy your life because of your problem? Amen. You want to end up this life. How many of you? I did it, brothers and sisters. Nung nalaman ko po yung daddy ko, they're watching right now, dad, please tayo. I'm just sharing my experience. I was, there's only one highway since, 1993. There's only one highway from Moharak to Manama, the old bridge. Ah, wala yung head, wala itong busaitin. No, only one. Nandun ako. Daddy ko ginawa niya ito. I was about to jump. I was about to jump. But I was trying to figure it out. It's low tide. Low tide. It's 5 o'clock in the afternoon. It's low tide. Lord! Maulog ako dito. Masakit. Hello? So I just hide. I just hide the baby in that, inaanap ako ng daddy ko. The whole Bahrain. Inaanap ako. Alam ni daddy, naalala niya. Nandun lang ako. Doon ako nag-stay, you know? Sometimes it happened to us. It happened. Amen. But this guy, when he saw Jesus from afar, when he saw Jesus, you know, nakita niya si Peter, nakita niya si Andrew, nakita niya si Bartholomew, nakita niya ang mga disciples, when he saw Jesus far off, malayo pa lang, he ran! He ran! He ran against him? No. He ran towards him. Yes. You know, how many devils he have? He was sitting all alone. Yung mga diablo, the devil spirit na nakahang sa kanya, nakasang, don't go to the church. Wala kang makukuha doon. Ha? Sesermonan ka lang ni pastor. Ha? Takakalkalin lang niya yung buhay mo. Wag, stay. Amen. But when you heard about the hope, amen, how many demons there with him? Almost 2,000. 2,000. Mamaya, legion, they said, legions around 6,000 troops. 6,000 troops. 6,000 evil spirits hanging over him. They don't want him to move. Di po ba? Pag gumagawa tayo ng kasalanan, di po ba? Parang feeling natin, daming mga demonyo na gumugulo sa isip natin. Right? Once you encounter the devils in your life, mapi sleep. Mapi sleep, Habibi. Amen. Tita, bana. You will go to the hospital. Madre, yan, mapi muskila. They will say, you are normal, but I feel lousy. No, lousy. There are certain spirits that hanging on you and trying to pull you out from light. So imagine, when he saw Jesus from afar, how many demons? 2,000 to 6,000 demons. Huh? Ano ginawa niya? He ran! And all the devil spirits, no, don't run! Don't go to the church! No! No, because you have the power of your will to change. You have to press towards the mark. You want to change. You want to change. I don't want this routine life. I don't want to live like this. When he saw Jesus far off, brothers and sisters, yung 2,000 to 6,000 diablo na naka-imbed sa kanya, he ran! Mamatay na kayo dyan! Ayaw ko na ng kasalanan! He ran! Woo! He ran! He ran! He ran! He ran! He ran! He ran! I know some people, mauupen sila sa next slide. I know some people will get offended in the next verse. But I'm telling you, when he saw Jesus far off, he ran and he worshiped. And he woo! And he worshiped him. He worshiped Jesus! Yes. Sino ba si Jesus? Huh. Sabi ng iglesia ni Cristo, Jesus is just a man. But the devils, they run. They are about to chase this guy. But he's sick and tired sa routine ng buhay. Amen. Laging patago ang relasyon. Laging may problema sa pera. Laging may problema sa buhay. Katatawag lang ng nanay mo, may sakit. Tumawag ang tatay mo, may sakit. Yung lolo mo nakaburol. Yung anak mo nagda-drugs. Oh my God! Those devil spirits, they are pulling you around. They are pulling you around. Amen. Kaya opportunity ngayon, dinala kayo ng Panginoon. I know, brothers and sisters, some of you, mabigat ang kaloob nyo na pumunta sa church, but I'm telling you, today is the day of salvation. Yeah. Woo! And he cried out with a loud voice and said, what have I to do with you, Jesus, Son of the Most High God? Implore you by God that you do not torment me. Imagine, in this Bible verse, this is the first time that the devils are praying to Jesus. Yung mga diablo na nanalangin kay Jesus, eh, tayo wala tayong time. Come on, alam na this. Son of the Most High, God, ang sabi sa James 2:19, thou believest that there is thou doest well. The devils also believe and tremble. And tremble. Nanginginig sila. Amen. Wow. Amen. For he said to him, ang sabi ni Jesus, come out of the man. Come out of the man. Unclean spirit. See, God knows. Jesus knows that there are unclean spirit. Dwell it in him. So alam ng kalaban. Alam ng Diyos ang kalaban. Sorry. Okay. Then he asked him, what is your name? See, Jesus Christ is very interested kung anong pangalan ng Habibi mo. Huh. Lord, apat sila. What is your name? And he answered saying, my name is Legion. Wow. Legion. For we are many. So how many spirits dwelleth in that guy? Oh my God, 6,000. 2,000 to 6,000. And then, this guy, also he begged him earnestly that he would not send them out of the country. Imagine the devils are begging to Jesus, please, Please, huwag mo kaming dalhin sa iba. Huwag mo kaming dalhin sa iba. Dali mo na. Dali mo yung espiritu kay kumare. Kay kumare na lang. Now, a large herd of swine was feeding there near the mountains. You know what swine, right? Pig. Sino kumakain ng pig dito? Pig. Masarap ang pig, di ba? Lalo na kapag pag nilagyan ng apple yan. Lechon na. But you know, when I studied in medicine, we found out that the swine, yung pig, there are 30 diseases na meron ng pig. 30 diseases. Kahit na i-boil mo siya, the trichinella spiralis, mga trichorera, trichuris, itong mga parasites, they're not easily die. Amen. But masarap. So all the demons beg him. All the demons beg him. Nagmamakaawa sila saying, send us to the swine. Send us to the swine that we may enter them. And at once, you know, if the devils are praying and Jesus answered their prayer, what more we as Christians praying to God na hindi sasagutin ng Panginoon, right? Wow! So all the demons beg him, saying, send us to the swine that you may enter them. And at once, Jesus gave them permission! Okay, gusto niya sa mga, as you wish, sige, punta kayo sa mga pig. Then the unclean spirits went out and entered the swine. There were about 2,000. And the herd ran violently down the steep place into the sea and drowned in the sea. See, imagine the pig. When the spirits came to them, naglipasag sila. No, we don't want the spirit. We don't want the spirit. We don't want the spirit. I don't want the spirit of adultery, fornication. Adultery, fornication. Ayaw. Anong ginawa nila? They commit suicide. The pigs committed suicide. Nabalitaan niyo yun? Na headline. The pigs committed suicide. Hindi sila nagkaroon ng swine flu. Because they don't want the spirit, that's why they died. They died. The tribes of Reuben, God, and the half of tribe of Manasseh soon began to forget the laws of God. See? Nakalimutan na nila kasi ang law of God. That's why they eventually end up raising pigs. Amen. Kaya yung mga umalis sa church, brothers and sisters, look at them. Look at them. Diba, sa praise and worship, meron tayong mga sinasabing, may mga rules and regulation tayo. Huwag na tayong magpakulay ng buhok because you are in the... Ayoko nang tuloy. In Mark 5:18-20, and when he got into the boat, he who had been demon-possessed begged him that it might be with him. Nag-iusap na, Lord, pwede na po ako sumama sa inyo. However, Jesus did not permit him, but said to him, ano sinabi ng Panginoon? Go home to your friends and tell them that great things the Lord has done for you and how he has had compassion on you. So imagine, brothers and sisters, kapag binago ko ng Panginoon, sinabi ng Lord, gamitin mo yung testimony mo. Tell your friends how God changed your life. Amen. What greater things that God has done for you and how He had compassion of you. Amen. Kaya yung mga kaibigan mo na nakabanig pa rin, nasa banig ng kasalanan, meron silang collections. Uy, ako may Turkish, ikaw meron ka. Meron akong Egyptian, meron ako, di ba? Pag nagkaroon sila ng collections, brothers and sisters, now you have the authority. Sister, alam ko hindi mo kaya yan. Hindi mo kaya yan. Pero kay Jesus, kayang-kaya niyan. Jesus, kayang-kaya niya ma-set free. Kaya, when I was in college, I was having some counseling sa Medicine for Jesus. Dito ka, Waki. Di na yung state ko na yan. Dito ka, anak. Sabi ko, Waki, kapag nagnanakaw, if you are taking some things that don't belong to you, what do you call them? A thief, right? A thief. Okay, sit down. Kasi we have some counseling, you know? So I just want to know that he knows kung ano yung problema niya. Sabi ko, kung kinuha mo, if you are taking some things that not belong to you, they call you what? A thief. Tama. If you are telling some lies to your parents, They call you what? A liar. A liar. A liar. So you know. Sabi sa kanya, brother, have you been commit a sin for your life? No. He said, no. Even once? No. Kapag may nakikita kang babae na maganda, sexy, umahawad, hindi ka ba nagkakasala? No. Seriously? No. Bakit? Ang sabi ni Waki, because I'm a gay. Just a joke. Kaya pala wala siyang interest, ano? Kaya pala nanonood siya ng Miss Universe. Kalalaki mong tao, nanonood ka ng Miss Universe. Sino na nanonood ka ng Miss Universe, Marcos? Amen. Diyan mo matetest ang tunay na lalaki. Pag nanonood ng Miss Universe. I'm watching you, ha? I'm my elders. And he departed and he began to proclaim, see, this man with infirmities, with devil spirit, he departed and began to proclaim in the Decapolis all that Jesus had done for him, and all marveled. See? All marveled. So God can change your life. If you want to change your life, not tomorrow, not next week, today, Habibi. That's why I was counseling Brother Eunice, one of my colleague in Alba. He's having some problem. I'm telling you, brother, you have problem in your chest right now because you consume cigarette too much. 2 packets, that is 40 sticks a day. 40 sticks a day. Wow, my God, I'm telling him. Come on, you have to stop. You have to stop smoking. You know, if I have the chance to take picture, you know, all the time in Tawara, you can see all the chronic obstructive pulmonary disease. You know, they cannot live without oxygen. At the age of 45, 50 years old, they are already in oxygen. My oxygen is free! It's free! But what happened? I think you have to stop smoking because your work will be in difficult situation. And then they'll tell, okay, I will try my best. See, you have the power in your own, the will. If you want to go for a change, if you will see Jesus far off, run. And not only running, ang sabi po, and they worship Him. If you want to be set free, all the demons, amen, embracing you, brothers and sisters, iwanan mo na sila. They cannot do anything. Tandaan nyo. You know, I was surprised because yesterday, me and my wife were praying while we were traveling to AMA and Alba. One of our prayers, sabi niya, Lord, ingatan mo po kami. Lord, do not allow even my Samuel and my dear Faith to have some bruises and contusions. Amen. We prayed. We know that we prayed that God will cover us. 3 o'clock in the afternoon, Samuel fell and he had some bruises and contusions. 3:30 in the afternoon, I was driving. I hate traffic violations. My God, I hate traffic violations. But in Sitra, I was shocked because, you know, it's free yesterday, 3:30 in the afternoon. No trucks around, nothing. I don't know what. It's a little bit strange. So I was moving my car around 90 kilometers per hour. And the limit only is 80. Nakot po ako ng camera. Sabi ko, Lord, nagpray po kami. Pero kasalanan ko. Hindi ko tinignan. 80 lang pala. You know? So sometimes Satan will try to deceive you, discourage you, amen, and to ruin your day, to ruin your life. But no, sabihin natin, it's only a bruise. It's only a bruise. At least walang contusion sa ulo si Sam. So still, it's a blessing, right? So brothers and sisters, if you have some visions in your life, press toward the mark. Kung ano man po yung gusto niyo sa buhay ninyo, I know you have a lot of things in your life. You want this, you want that. Nobody can help you but yourself. Nobody can help you but yourself. I'm telling you right now, you have the chance to meet the Master. You have the chance to meet God. You have the chance to meet the Savior. You have the chance to meet and talk to Jesus, brothers and sisters. If I were you, take the opportunity. Run! Iwanan mo na yung yesteryears mo. Iwanan mo na yung nakalipas mo. You have a better future. Come on, tell yourself, I have a better future. Do not rely. Ano po, dahil tutustusin kasi mahal ako ng habibi ko ngayon. He can supply all my needs according sa kanyang packet. No, God can give the desires of your heart in a nice way, in a good way. Amen. Kaya stop making excuses. I know, masakit ang word of God, but it will set you free. It will set you free. Amen. I hope next week, brothers and sisters, nandito pa rin po tayo. Nandito tayo. And we will help each other na malampasan po natin ang mga pagsubok sa buhay natin. Amen. And I know that God is doing things right now sa buhay mo. God is talking to you right now. It's up to you. It's your decision. If you will stay like this, kalas, yani, it's your problem. But if you want to move forward and press toward the mark, do it right now. Press forward. Press toward the goal. Press toward the mark. Amen. Ang tagal ka nang inihintay ng Panginoon, kapatid. Alam mo ba yon? Ngayon, na-encounter mo na siya. It's up to you. It's up to you. Amen. God can use your testimonies para makapag-win pa ng maraming soul. Amen. Let's bow our heads and pray. Let's worship the Lord. Come on, church. Let's worship the Lord. Heavenly Father, Lord God Jesus, we thank you, Father, for this wonderful opportunity to hear your word. I know your word is quick and powerful, O Lord God Jesus. I don't know bakit ako dinala dito sa lugar na ito. I don't know bakit pinayagan ko pa itong kaibigan ko to be in this church. Ngayon, nakalkal pa kung ano yung meron akong buhay. And that's God. That's how God works, brothers and sisters. Sometimes we're going to the hospital because we don't know what's going on in us. And then they will eventually put you in an x-ray, they will put you in CT scan, they will put you in MRI, and all the things that you have, it will be revealed. It will be shown. The reason why God brought you here, because you need healing. God brought you here because God loves you. He doesn't want you to get hurt. Kaya nga po, do not rely on your yesteryears. Today is a day of salvation. And I know God will rescue us right now. Give us, O Lord God, Jesus, comfort. Give us forgiveness, O Lord God, Jesus. Nawa, Panginoon Lord, ang lahat po na nakinig ng iyong salita, they will be set free right now. Set free, O Lord God, Jesus. We don't want to live in cemetery. We don't want to live in loneliness. We want to live in your presence. We want to live in your holy presence. We want to be with you, Jesus. We want to adore you, to glorify you, to worship you. Kaya ano, alam po namin, Panginoon Lord, ang araw na ito ay araw ng kaligtasan. Let your words be upon us today and forever. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen, amen, and amen. God bless you, church. God bless you. Amen.
Amen. Purihin po ang Panginoon. Napaganda po ng message. No? Gaano man po ang ating mga buhay, gaano man kamisirable, gaano man ang kasalanan, nandyan ang ating Panginoon nagpapatawad. Amen. Kaya magalak po tayo. Praise God. Hallelujah. Mahal na mahal kita, Panginoon. Mahal po ba natin ating Panginoon? Amen. Alam ninyo, minsan kung hindi kayo makasayaw, bakit? Spiritually, may mga nakaganon na mga spirit. Hindi po ba? Minsan hindi mo maitaas yung kamay mo. Bakit? May spirit eh. Halika dito. Halika dito, Brother Max. Kunwari ako yung spirit. Worshipper siya, di po ba? Ang spirit po, lalo na kung ano pa yung sa Japanese, yung mga sumo wrestler. Naku, mabigat po yan eh, no? Tignan mo, makakapag-worship ka ba?
No.
Mag-worship ka nga, bro? Mag-worship ka? No. Kaya hindi ka makamag-worship eh, no? Makakasayaw ka ba? Makakasayaw ka? Kaya hindi ka makasayaw eh. Pero, kapag pinilit mo yan, halimbawa, siya naman yung spirit. Kapag pinilit mo, yakap ka. Pag ganun-ganun ka na. Nasaan siya? Nakakakita ba sa akin? Sige, kumapit ka! Kumapit ka!
ng demonyo! Hindi! Hallelujah! Woo! Mahal na mga kayang Panginoon! Come on! Hallelujah! Come on! Woo!
Mahal na mahal kita, Panginoon.
Come on!
Mahal na mahal. Mahal na mahal kita, Panginoon. Kailan ay di ang magpapalit at sa piling mo'y lagi. Mahal na mahal kita, Panginoon.
Habang buhay!
Habang buhay habang buhay, maglilingkod sa iyo. Habang buhay, maglilingkod sa iyo. Iyalan,
mahal na mahal kita, Panginoon.
Mahal na mahal kita, Panginoon. Mahal na mahal kita, Panginoon. Kailan pa'y di kita'y pagpapalit, pagkat sa piling mo'y lagi. Mahal na mahal kita, mahal na mahal kita, mahal na mahal kita, Panginoon.
Hallelujah! Woo-hoo! Peace be with you! Praise God! Hallelujah!